So students, let's start our computer class chapter 3. We had completed chapter 2 in our last class, and today we are going to start chapter 3, more features of MS Word. In this chapter, we'll try to understand about working with autocorrect and autotext feature, including date and time, adding a watermark, inserting symbols, adding borders, round text and on a page. Let me show you your ebook first of all, so that it will be a little easier for you all. Shubhran, start reading. Take off to begin the class.
Okay.
From here, read from here. Autocorrect.
Okay, ma'am. Autocorrect. This feature automatically corrects many common typing and spelling errors as you type. It is also a great way to use shorthand for longer words, phrases, or symbols. To use autocorrect feature, follow the step. Step number one, go to the file tab. Step number two, in the backstage view and select option. Step number three, the word options window appears. Four, select the proofing options in the left pane. Five, then click the autocorrect option button in the right pane. Six, the autocorrect dialog box appears on the autocorrect tab. Make sure the replace text as you type check box is selected. Seven, in the replace field, type a word or phrase that you often mistype or misspell. For example, type grupo. In the with field, type the correct spelling of the word. For example, type group. 8. Click the add button and close the autocorrect dialog box. Auto text. If you have blocks of text,
start reading autocorrect.
Yes, ma'am. Auto text. If you have blocks of text that you need typed out frequently in a document, you can use auto text feature to insert them by typing a short code instead. This feature helps you save time in typing out frequently used text. To use auto text feature, follow the steps. First, select a text or content that you need to save as auto text. Second, go to the insert tab and click the down arrow next to the quick parts button in the text group. The auto text gallery appears. Third, select save selection to quick part gallery from the list. Fourth, the date and time dialog box appears. Fifth, choose the format of data and time from the dialog box. Sixth,
page number 34. You are reading page number 36.
Okay, ma'am. Fourth, the create new building block dialog box appears. Fifth, change the name of the auto text entry and add a description if you want. Sixth, click the down arrow on save in and choose normal. Seventh, then click the OK button. To ensure that your auto text entry works, first, place your cursor where you want to insert the auto text. Second, type in the abbreviation or the name of the autotext. Third, you will notice that once you type the fourth letter of the name, in this case auto, a prompt appears as shown figure 2.5. Fourth, press the enter key to insert the entire block of expanded text. Inserting date and time.
Inserting date and time.
Third, inserting that date and time. In Microsoft Word 2013, you can quickly insert the current date and time into the body of our documents as well as into the header and footer. To insert cursor, current date and time in a document, follow these steps. First, place the cursor where you want to insert the date and time. Second, go to the insert tab. Third, click the date and time button in the text group. Fourth, the date and time dialog box appears. Fifth, choose the format of date and time from the dialog box. Note, in case you need your documents to reflect the current date and time at all time, check the update automatically option. Click the OK button to close the dialog box. The current date and time is inserted in your documents. Third, watermarks.
Shraddha Patel, start reading from watermarks.
Ma'am, I have drawn book.
You can see the book on your screen. That's why I am showing you this book, the e-book. That's why I am.
Okay, ma'am. Have you seen very light, nearly invisible text? Do not copy or picture such as company logos on documents. These appear in the background in a dimmed out manner with the actual content of the document. These are watermarks. It can be seen in print layout view or in a printed document. Watermarks help to denote the type of a document and how a document can be used. For example, watermarks indicate that a document's a private confidently for private circulation, etc. International watermarks. World has a collection of a watermarks text which are ready to use as a native. मैम यहाँ पे मैं नहीं
alternately custom text can also be included at work as watermark. I think your network is unstable, Shraddha.
Yes.
Who will read now? Anjali, start reading from inserting watermarks.
Inserting watermark. Word has a collection of watermark tags which are ready to use. Alternately, custom tags can also be included as watermarks. To insert watermarks in a document, follow the steps. First, go to the design tab. Second, click the watermark button in the page background group. Third, the watermark gallery appears. Select a watermark. Example, do not copy one from the gallery. The desired watermark is inserted to your document. Four, to view the watermark, click the print layout view button in the status bar.
Stop now. Maheen Kumari. Start reading from here, 3.4.2, creating custom watermark. Start reading, creating custom watermark.
Creating custom watermark. You can create your own text watermark using custom watermark option. The create your own watermark. Follow the steps. First, go to the design tab. Second, click the watermark button in the page background group. Third, in the watermark gallery, click the custom watermark option. Fourth, in the printed watermark dialog box, select text watermark. Fifth, enter the text that you need as a watermark in the text file. You can change
text field,
font type, size and color of the watermark text. Six, click the OK button to apply the watermark to your document. Seven, to view the watermark, click the print layout view button in the custom bar.
Stop. Purva Dwivedi, start reading. Do you have book, Purva? Akshat, start reading. 3.5, inserting symbol.
Ma'am, the picture is not clearly.
Shami Gautam.
Ma'am.
Shami Gautam, start reading. Can you see the picture?
Yes, ma'am.
Inserting symbol.
Interesting. In inserting symbols. Symbols are mark of characters that can be used for writing mathematical and scientific. Ma'am, ye kya hai?
Notations,
some symbols such as
1/4
and special characters such as characters such as an dash,
M dash,
and dash, or that are not on your keyboard. To insert such symbols and characters, follow the step. Step 1, place the
cursors
where you want to insert the symbols. Second, go to the insert tab. Third, click the symbols button in the symbols group. It display the symbol gallery. Fourth, if you see the symbol you want listen on the gallery, just click into insert. Fifth, it is symbol that you want to insert. If is not in the list, click the more symbols option.
Symbol dialog box appear.
Number
6.
In the found box, click the font that you want. Seventh, click the symbol that you want to insert. Eighth, then click the insert button. Ninth, click the close button to close the symbol dialogs box. The required symbol is inserted into the document.
Stop now. Yogesh Bajaj, start reading the next topic, 3.6, including borders. Where are you? Yogesh Bajaj. Including borders. Yogesh Bajaj, start reading. Yes, Pranjal. Pranjal Mishra, name is written here. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Text paragraphs or pages in the required names.
3.6.1, adding border to text. To add borders around the text, follow the steps. Step 1, select the text or paragraph to which you want to add a border. Go to the design lab. Step 3, click the page borders button in the page background groups. It opens the borders and sharing dialog box. Step 4, click the border tabs. Step 5, select a border for the text. Step 6, then click the OK button.
Stop. Yeshi, start reading from here. Adding border to a page.
Adding border to a page. To add borders to a page, follow the step. Step 1, go to the design tab. Step 2, click the page borders button in the page background group. It opens the borders and shading dialog box. Step 3, click the page border tab. Step 4, select a border for the page. Step 5, then click the OK button. Adding borders, figure 3.15, adding border to a page, hots. It is possible to add border to text without opening the borders and shading dialog box. If yes, describe the alternate method.
Okay, now, let me explain this chapter to you all. This chapter is all about MS Word. What you can do in this MS Word of operating system Windows 10. Understand? So, as you can see on your book, I can't show this MS Word on your screen because my system is of operating 7, OS 7. Windows 7 is on my system, my computer. So I can't show you Windows 10 MS Word. So you have to understand the whole thing from your book, which is given in page number 32, that how to autocorrect. We have to go to the file tab, backstage view. We have to select backstage view option. Let me show you on your this ebook. Here, for autocorrect, how to autocorrect, we have to go to the file tab, backstage view, we have to select from the options, word options, then select the proving options, then autocorrect options, we have to click on that button. Then whenever we click on that, then if we write some wrong option, some wrong words, that word will be autocorrected by that MS Word, by itself. Understand, we don't have to correct it. Like, for example, it is given here, if we will write the spelling of group, G-R-O-P-U, then it will be auto-correct like G-R-O-U-P. This is the procedure how to add auto-correct option. Now, move to the auto-text. Auto-text. For adding auto-text, some steps are given here which you have to follow. Select the text or contents that you need to save as auto text. Then you have to go to the insert tab and click down the arrow next to the quick part. This is the steps which you have to learn. Read it and learn it. Next topic is 3.3, page number 35. Inserting date and time. How to insert date and time? In Microsoft 2013, you can quickly insert date and time. How can we add date and time? These steps are given. Place the cursor where you want to insert date and time. Go to the insert tab. Click the date and time button in the text group. And the date and time dialog box will appear. You can see here like this. If you have book, open figure 3.6. There you can see by these steps we can add date and time on our MS Word 2013. Watermarks. How to add watermarks? Here, the procedure is given. You have to read them. And what is watermark? First of all, you have to learn that. These How can you see very lightly, nearly? What are watermarks? How many of you can tell me what is watermark? Raise your hands. कितने बच्चे मुझे बता सकते हैं that what is watermark? What do you understand by watermark? From here, autocorrect, you all have to write this whole. After that, write down up to, in your book, mark it up to page number 35. The last option is given in the fourth point. Press the enter key to insert the entire block to expand text. Up to there, mark this answer. Four questions, no, three questions we have completed. Na? Write the steps to include correct current date and time in the document. I hope you found out that date and time option on page number. Where is date and time? Tell me the page number. Setting date and time, 3.3, page number 35. So from to insert current date. To insert correct date. To insert correct date. Write down from here. Step 6. Up to step 6. Okay?
Excuse me, ma'am.